Alrighty, we're going to try doing a flight in the King Air C90B from Anchorage to Valdez for stream. Just to get the bugs worked out, see if I can get it to do its thing. So, we've got a checklist for this thing. Let's see. Take a little exterior view. Pre-start, gears down, brake set. Avionics should be off. Battery off. Power idle. I'll get my levers synchronized here. Props full. And condition at cut. And the doors are closed. Right, doors are closed. Doors closed. Now, I'm also going to bring up my tablet so I can actually look at my checklist on here. Let's see, doors closed, speed air off. It's over here on the right. Right, left, fuel transfer is off, 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 okay. All right, begin the start checklist. Turn battery on. Turn on a beacon. Fuel cargo, so we want to go into the flight menu, weight and balance. For this particular flight, we have a total payload weight of 1150. Represents the 5 passengers. Pretty close. Total internal fuel, also known as a block fuel, 1167 pounds. That should get us to Valdez and back again if we need to. Give it a moat to get it set together on that one. Alright, we're back. Enunciator. Should have a bunch of these things make sense. Turn the inverter on to start the engines. Choose inverter number 2. And we want to turn engine anti-ice on. What this does is prevent crap from getting sucked into. Stuff from getting sucked into the engine. Boy, it's been a while since I've flown this. I don't remember. Oh, here it is. Yeah, so actually we already have anti-ice already on. And the right, left. We're going to start the right engine first, so we'll start the right boost pump. Auto ignition on. We're going to look at the... look at. And then we click the starter. And we're looking for turbine of about 12%, and then we'll increase the condition to low idle. You can see that on the right here. We want to get our turbine up to 50%. can give it, you see fuel flowing, everything looks kind of normal. Switch to high idle. Let that stabilize. And then we want to turn off the starter. Turn the generator on and reset it. And I can do the same thing for the left side. Now when this gets up to 50%, we're good. Turn off the starter. Turn on the generator for that engine. Bring both condition levers back to low idle. And we're going to look at our enunciator. We have a indicator for electric pitch trim. We'll get to that in a moment. I could check voltages, but that should be alright. Set right left fuel transfer to auto. Auto feather to arm. Flaps retracted. Avionics on. This panel, the trim on, flight director on, we'll set our, while we're here, set our cabin altitude, 15,000 feet, so I'll set that to 15. And check our flight plan. We're supposed to have our flight plan here. Did not work. Okay. So I'll have to enter that by hand. get on one in there, but I cannot remember how to get rid of it. There. There we go. If I want to do this, it's just an airway. I don't think. No. Okay. That be. Forgot to enter my airport. We're going to PA Papa Alpha Victor Delta. Approach. All right. All right. We want to keep an eye also on our taking off runway 25 left. And I want to know about our taxiways. I'm going to go down to taxiway Charlie. All right. All right, let's go back to our checklist. Flight plan is entered, stamp transponder. It's already on 1200. I think that's what we want. Doesn't really matter. If we were flying on VATSIM, we'd have a transponder squawk code. We're going to be cruising it. feet. So I'm going to set that as our initial altitude. Flying under ATC, we'd probably get something else to start with. And I'll put in the runway heading. We forgot our 5. So we'll set up heading, climb. And we'll engage the autopilot when we're ready to do so. Telemetry setting, I looked at the weather conditions for Anchorage, and altimeter is 2958. Says we have elevation of 151. Actually, near where we are on this airport, elevation is 100 feet, so that's right on the money. Yep, turn on the seatbelt sign. Taxi lights. Yeah, we're gonna turn heat on for everything. Our temperature is above freezing, but we're gonna get into some cold air after we take off. And cabin temperature will be set to auto. So let's out getting ourselves taxied out here. Okay, just want to make sure we have flight logging software running. Good. I'm not on the taxiway. Where am I? Here we go. So this is a sloppy taxi. At this point, I would be asking for permission from ATC to cross 25R. Let's assume we've got that. Check for traffic. Yeah, we're good. Go right across and take a sharp right. Bring us to 25L. have been cleared for takeoff. So this 25L, that is what we want. Get ourselves lined up with a heading bug. Okay. Before takeoff, condition high, idle. Boost trim. Five up. Last one notch down. Landing lights on. Take off, we have props full. High idle. Power. Okay, so what we're gonna do is watch the power as we go. We get off the ground, we'll engage our autopilot. Gonna watch ITT. Turbine and torque. We have to take it out of something messed up about this runway. Heading bug around. Nav mode. Alright, we're heading into some rain, so we do want to make sure we keep all our ice protection on. And we want to keep an eye on ice buildup on the wings, and occasionally activate the wing de-ice. We want to keep an eye also on our intercept of this flight plan. See if we pick up this white line and turn it into magenta. Meanwhile, okay, looks like we're making a turn onto that line. Let's see if our climb checklist is done. Gear is up. Lights off. Flaps retracted. We want the power at about 90%. Bring back the prop. Oh, sorry, turn auto feather off. Bleed air on. Will give us oxygen. Cabin altitude is set. Probably want the butt back. I'm gonna keep an eye on our other gauges, make sure nothing bad happens. Prop to 2000 RPM. And we can do prop sync. Alright, so we need to activate this leg. Now, actually, don't know how well this particular airplane shows ice buildup. Should also turn on shield anti-ice. Temperatures outside is now negative 10. Sounds like somebody's brought that baby into the cockpit. So now would be a good time to look at our descent profile. Get our head wrapped around that. At least 7,800 feet at Pepe. I'm sorry, Oleo. Over here, let me check our. Dispatch release. So our top of our descent is somewhat after Pepe. Fast approaching 1.5. And when we hit cruising altitude, we want to keep an eye on our speed, make sure we do not go too fast. Here, our speed climbing. Since we're going to be doing this Pepe approach, we could just say at this point activate approach. So we are now going direct to Pepe. Approach is activated. And now the reason I wanted to do that is I wanted to be able to think about our descent to Oleo, which we want to be at about 8,000 feet. We have only about 13 minutes until we need to begin our descent, so it's a very short time at cruise. At this point, I do also know, I checked the weather before departing, that our altimeter setting for Valdez was different, so I'm going to dial that in now. 2977. Power on the right engine. Yep. Looking good. Band of clouds. little thinking about this next step. So from Olio, in a very few miles, we go from about 8,000 feet down nearly sea level. And the last piece, we have 6 miles, we have to drop 5,500 feet. That's 1 mile in six. That's a very steep angle. So my plan is to use the IAS indicated airspeed, autopilot mode, maintain an approach speed of about 120 knots, and use power to control our descent rate. We should be starting our turn to the left. We're seeing some pretty exciting weather here. Our altitude has been bouncing around, and that's affecting our airspeed. It's a little frightening. We're probably going to be sick to our stomachs. Weather in Valdez is supposed to be pretty decent. Well, winds calm, scattered clouds at various altitudes should be very agreeable. Hit that de-ice boot just to be on the safe side. I don't even know what it does for sure. Is it really working the simulator? But I don't want to find out. I have been doing a lot of flying in Alaska during cold weather, and not paying attention to the icing will definitely take you down. So when I hit the begin descent, I'm going to activate, slow to about 120 knots, activate IAS on the autopilot, and adjust power to achieve approximately 1,500 feet per minute descent. During our final approach to Valdez, we'll need to have about 2,000 feet per minute descent, covering that last 6 miles in about 3 minutes. So we need to do about 6,000 feet of descent in 3 minutes. Actually, I take that back. For Oleo, I think I want to maintain my speed. And at Oleo, I'll adjust for 120 knots. Alright, breaking through some clouds. Beautiful view somewhere out there. Lurking out there, or a little bit to our left. Alrighty, let's try this. Descent rate of about 1500, taking a moment to stabilize. Should set my target altitude though. That would be a good idea. Going to use descent mode, so I'm more familiar with that. watching the vertical speed required, which is actually not that great, so bringing my power back to idle. And we're only 5 miles from Olio, so it's about working out okay. When we get to level off, we'll let the speed drop to 120. Try dialing in final altitude. Ourselves our approach flaps. So now we go, oh, that's perfect, 8,000 feet. I'm going to dial in the 6,400 for PAVD. Let our speed knock off to 120. Dial in. Now the aircraft is going to try to maintain about 120 knots by controlling our pitch. And we're looking for 6,400 when we reach PAVD. And go to 6,000 at Chican. Floating, so I'm going to throw in, we're going slow enough, I can throw in another level of flap, so we're at full flaps. And I'm going to dial our altitude down to 6,000. Picking up the localizer. We're gonna put our gear out. We're gonna need to get that descent rate down. Pass of caution, reverser not ready. We're gonna have to have props full in order to activate the reverser. We're not actually close to landing. Okay, look up, we went 5,500. We are... actually low for Lokip, so I'm gonna add power to lower descent and pass Lokip so we can increase our target altitude. Is there a runway? Cut her descent rate. We're coming in too low now. So now, literally, in this autopilot mode, I'm literally using the throttles to control our descent rate. So I'm ready to switch off the autopilot and make a manual descent. Should be pretty straightforward. Lights on. Flaps are full. first off, autopilot. Make a little dog leg here. We are a little high according to the poppy lights. But I am happy with it. Reverse is on, so we get to about 50. And we are in Valdez, Alaska. Very nice. Ourselves a place to park. All righty. Do a little shutdown. Anti-ice is on already. Auto feather is off. Auto ignition off for both engines. Retract flaps. Set pitch trim to 0. Transponder off. Condition is on low idle. Brakes are set. Powered idle. Props. Feather. And condition cut. Boost pumps off. External lights off. Avionics off. Battery off. And that's how you do it.